Bobby, what are you doing up so late? What are you looking at? Bobby? Bobby?
Oh, Dougie, it's you, thank God.
Who'd you expect?
I've been watching the Dumpermires' house.
Been watching the Dumpermires through their bedroom window?
I don't like the look of this at all, Dougie.
What do you expect? Mrs. Dumpermire weighs 18 stone.
Something really big shaking over there, man.
She's doing aerobics again.
Yeah. You have a look.
Well, I hate aerobics.
Just look. Look.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
No, not her. There, in the yard, that guy.
Huh?
Look, he's dressed in black. He's digging a hole.
I can't see a thing. It's pitch black out there.
But he's gone now.
Hey, Mr. Dumpermire?
No, not the Dumplemires. The guy they're renting to.
Eh?
There's something going on over there, Dougie.
Eh?
Something weird.
What?
I don't know. But I'm getting bad vibes about it, man. Real bad vibes.
Well, I'm going to bed, Bobby. Night.
Yeah, night, Dougie. Oh, Dougie! Sleep well, man.
What was that?
Smelt like Bobby.
At 9 o'clock in the morning?
Running?
Yeah, it was Bobby. He's climbing a tree at the side of the house.
What for?
Trying to see into next door. He's just about there. Fell on his head.
At least it was nothing important.
Bobby, what's going on?
There's something really weird out there.
Oh, don't worry about it, Bobby. It's come inside now.
No, man. This is serious. I think we've got a problem with next door.
The Dumplemires?
No, not the Dumplemires, the guy they rented to.
Well, what is it?
Well, I'll tell you, but first you've got to promise not to say I'm crazy.
Just go on, Bobby.
All right. Last night, I was watching the yard, and there was this guy digging a hole.
Oh, that's called working.
I didn't know there was anybody that rented next door.
Yeah. That's because he's only there at night. In the dead of night.
Yeah?
And he always wears black.
Yeah?
And he buries things at night.
Yeah?
And he takes the soil and moves it into the house.
Yeah?
He's a vampire.
You're crazy.
Look, I know a lot about the supernatural. One bite from a vampire and you're a mindless zombie.
That's amazing. You can't even see the puncture marks.
This is serious, man. You could all be in danger.
Oh, right, Bobby. He must have heard there was a virgin in the neighborhood.
Maybe.
Maybe he heard there were two.
Bobby, there are no such things.
Well, virgins?
Of course there are.
No! There's vampires. They don't exist. That is a perfectly normal house, and whoever is in it is also perfectly normal.
There's a removal van there now.
See? Perfectly normal.
Unloading a coffin.
Yeah, and when they opened up the coffin 100 years later, there was nothing in it but the bones of a horse, Dougie. That's a fact. And this is not a comic book.
No, it's a real book.
See?
There wouldn't be anything in there about vampires, would there?
Vampires.
Myths and legends of Transylvania.
All right. Maybe there's a bit about vampires.
Oh, Bobby, there are no such things.
Oh, I don't know, Trace. The facts are pretty impressive.
Oh, what facts?
Anna, there are documented stories in there through the ages about people who kill just because they crave human blood.
But they're ancient myths.
Well, there was one on Donahue last week.
Dougie, I don't see how someone can die every night and keep coming back.
Well, Bobby did. Remember that tour in 1975?
Yeah. Thanks, Dougie. Cool.
Oh, I don't know what you're getting so paranoid over. I mean, a few unexplained murders.
Anna, remember the facts. Fact number one. Dracula was a real historical person. B. Vampires are just like cockroaches. You can kill them, but they keep coming back. Fact number three. The other guys out at the taxi rank, they've seen some pretty weird things being delivered next door.
No, they could say the same about this house.
Oh, they delivered coffins, did they, Trace?
Bobby, that wasn't a coffin, it was a grandfather clock.
Trace, there are lots of unexplained mysteries in the world. What about the Bermuda Triangle? What about the Easter Island statues? The Bay City Rollers?
Bobby, what sort of creature would spend its entire existence sucking the lifeblood out of its innocent victims?
Hello, beautiful people!
So I was wrong.
Chicky Bay. You know, the sound of your voice makes my eyes light up.
So does shining a torch in your ear.
Wayne, what do you know about vampires?
Vampires?
Oh, don't tell me you believe in them as well.
Junior Cheeky Babe. You should never knock the supernatural. You don't know who might be listening.
But, Wayne, there are no such things as vampires.
Oh, yeah? That's what my great-grandfather said.
Your great-grandfather?
That's right, Chicky Babe. I mean, back in the old country, you know. I mean, one day it was, I don't believe in vampires. The next it was... Was it good for you too, Chicky Babe?
What happened to your great-grandfather, man?
What great-grandfather?
The one with the vampires.
Oh, that great-grandfather. Nothing much. He just burnt to the stake, you know.
Well, I've heard enough weird stories to last me a lifetime. We've got some gardening to finish before it starts raining.
Yeah, Chicky Babe. I hope you'll be thinking of me.
Oh, I will, Wayne. It's a vegetable garden.
Wayne, what really happened with your grandfather?
You guys really want to know more?
Yeah.
Well, it's pretty ugly stuff.
Oh, come on, man, lay it on us.
All right, don't tell me I didn't warn you. It actually started a long time ago. From, Listen, guys, take a seat, will you? It started with my great-grandfather's fourth cousin, Salvatore. Yeah, I think it was... The year was in the Renaissance. He was a painter. Village was never seen again.
Wow.
Gee, you know, these vampires, they're pretty powerful, aren't they? I mean, they can turn into mist, Bobby, and they can turn into bats. You can't even take photographs of them.
Ducky, they're Their reflection doesn't even show up in the mirror.
How do they shave?
You know, the only way you can kill them is with a stake right through the heart.
And you know they have hypnotic powers over women.
Oh, imagine that, being completely irresistible to women.
Yeah, it's a gift. So anyway, guys, so why the sudden interest in vampires?
The guy next door.
What, the guy next door wants to know about vampires?
No, the guy next door is a vampire, Wayne.
What? How did you invite me here with a vampire living next door?
Wayne, we never invite you here.
That's it, that's it.
A vampire can't hurt you unless you invite him into your home.
That's right.
Oh, thank heavens we didn't do that.
Oh, guess who Anna and I just met?
Who?
Our next door neighbour. I've invited him over for dinner tonight.
Oh, man, what are we going to do?
Oh, I don't know, mate. Lucky we've got Wayne here.
Where's Bobby and Doug?
Well, they told me they had to dress for dinner.
Dress for dinner, Bobby and Doug? Wearing those?
Oh, there's been a lot of cold weather around, Trace. So I got them for everybody, see?
This wouldn't have anything to do with that vampire nonsense, would it?
Oh, no. There's been some bats right through around.
Now that will be our guest. And you'll see he's just a perfectly normal, everyday sort of person.
Good evening.
That's made things a bit lighter. Well, make yourself at home. I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
My apologies. My name is Gary. But please, call me Gazza.
Well, why don't we sit down? Thomas, could you get the roast, please?
Sure, Trace.
Ladies, please allow me.
Oh.
Remember what the book said? Total control over women. I'll check to see if he casts a reflection.
Trace, here. Allow me.
Oh, Bob.
Diana.
Sorry. Well, here we go. Something we can really sink our teeth into.
Thomas.
Sorry, because of the power failure, it's probably a little bit underdone.
Ah, but that's just the way I like it.
Plenty of blood, hey?
That's a very interesting accent, Gazza.
You were on Sesame Street, were you? Gravy?
My accent is Romanian. Some people think it sounds like something out of a Dracula movie. I must confess, my name is not really Gary. I had a change when I originally came to this country. And originally, it was Igor.
Oh, that's a lovely name.
Well, it used to get some strange reactions from people.
Never really noticed this tray before. It's very fascinating. What do you think, Gaz?
So, Gazza, where are you from originally?
Ah, from a tiny little state in the north of Romania. You've probably never heard of it.
Transylvania?
Ah, you have heard of it. Are you all right? Perhaps you should loosen those scars. Tell me, why do you wear such terrible things?
Stop my neck getting bitten. Frostbitten in the weather.
Yeah, we don't want to catch a cold, you know. I mean, all that sneezing and coughing. Coughing?
Oh, yes, yes. You must be very careful. A cold can very easily turn into something more...
grave?
Exactly.
I didn't even know there was anywhere called Transylvania.
Oh, yes. That's where my family is. Or was.
Yeah. Yes!
Doug!
store gathered like a souvenir of the evening.
Well, if we're all finished, let's have some dessert, shall we?
An excellent idea.
Oh! Ow! That knife was sharper than I thought.
You okay?
Yeah, it's just a nick.
But you're bleeding. You need some attention. Why don't you let me fix it for you?
No, that's fine. I'll just suck it.
As you like.
Trace, we can't have dessert. The power's off. Oh, sorry, Gary.
But why don't you come to my house for dessert?
Your house?
Yes. I have some excellent Romanian mango cake. I think you'll find it very surprising.
I didn't think they grew mangoes in Romania.
Well, they don't. That's what makes it so surprising. But I guarantee one bite, and you'll never be the same again. Shall we go?
Trace, don't do this. It's very dangerous. I tried to warn you.
Guys, you're not under his spell too, are you?
Don't be silly, Dougie. We're just hungry.
Don't do that, Thomas.
You're right. It's mango cake. You wouldn't like it.
Tracy!
Come on. Are you coming?
We'll be over in about 5 minutes, man. We've just got to pick some stuff up, right, Dougie?
Yeah, we'll be there.
I'll be waiting for you.
Everything that was on the list, I got Mama to pack the box for.
Okay, Wayne, where's the garlic?
Wayne, this is garlic bread. We need fresh garlic.
Yeah, but this is better. And it keeps in the freezer, too. Mama reckons you can have it for breakfast, huh?
What about the steaks?
It's gotta be here somewhere. Here it is.
This is no good, man.
What do you expect for 83 cents a kilo?
Wayne, you were supposed to get wooden steaks.
I know, but Mama must have made a mistake when she was in the kitchen.
No one ever killed anyone with a T-bone steak.
My cousin Alfonso did. All right, long story.
What about the crucifix? Did you get the crucifix?
Okay, look. Father O'Reilly wasn't in, so I had to stop by Rabbi Feldman's.
So I suppose you didn't get the holy water either.
I did too.
That's chicken soup.
Yeah, blessed by the rabbi himself.
What good is chicken soup, man?
You ever seen a Jewish vampire?
Man, what are we gonna do?
Well, why don't you get some bowls, Dougie? Maybe we can have a little bit.
Look, here's what we'll do, right? We'll have to go in the back way and make do. All for one.
Yeah, and one for all.
Oy vey.
Kid, I thought you were next door, giving the vampire indigestion.
Bobby, Dougie, you guys were right. It was terrible.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. One bite.
Oh!
Oh! Where's Tracy and Anna?
Oh, they're still over there. Can you believe it? They actually liked it.
All right. You just relax, Thomas. We're gonna go in and get them out, aren't we, guys?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Yeah!
It's the worst cake I ever ate.
Cake?
Yeah, the Romanian mango.
Cake.
Is that chicken soup I can smell?
It's a weapon!
You're back.
Yeah, we're back. Oh, you're not still going on about this vampire stuff, are you?
Well, we...
You really think Gary's a vampire?
Yeah.
He's a naturopath. The stuff that you saw being delivered is his medical equipment.
Yeah?
For his surgery. He's only rented out next door for a month until it's ready, and that's where he is all day.
What about the digging of the hole?
Yeah, the digging?
Yeah, well, the digging that Bobby saw was just Gary working in the garden.
Burying Mrs. Dumplemeyer.
Taking soil inside for his herbs.
Ah!
For his work. Ah! Look, let's face it, Bobby, you were wrong.
Yeah, all right. I might have overreacted a bit. Maybe he wasn't a vampire. I'm sorry, but I was only trying to protect you guys, that's all.
I'm sorry too. I was just protecting him.
Garlic bread, chicken soup, everybody?
Still hot?
Yeah, stick your face in and find out, kid. Chicky babe, why don't I give you a little hand here? Nice photo, Bob. How about this guy's vampires, huh?